There's a natural supplement that may shrink the plaque in your arteries, but nobody's talking about it. Over 20 years ago, a team of scientists in the US was looking at calcium in the artery wall. As the plaque in our arteries grows over time, it can start to show specks of calcium. And there's even a calcium score that measures the amount of calcium in someone's arteries. So they followed a group of individuals over 1 year, and as expected, the calcium score in average went up. But they discovered that if they gave those participants a garlic supplement, it slowed down that calcium accumulation. They used what's called aged garlic extract. So they split their participants randomly. They gave one half the supplement of aged garlic extract, and they gave a placebo to the other half. And the trial was double blind, meaning that they didn't know which one they were getting. And the investigators were also blinded. Each participant, they didn't know which group they were in. And 1 year later, the participants receiving the garlic supplement had less calcium growth than the participants getting the placebo. And it was a big difference. Like three times the calcium increase. So this is a really interesting result. Now, there's a number of questions that were left. For example, calcified plaque is actually more stable. So the calcium serves as a indicator of how long the plaque's been growing and how much plaque in general the person has. But a calcified plaque is actually more stable, less vulnerable, less likely to burst and to cause a heart attack. So is the garlic actually slowing down plaque growth, and is it a good thing, or is it just blocking calcification and making the plaque more vulnerable, and is it a bad thing? So another study looked at total plaque, not just calcified plaque, but total plaque volume over time. And they saw that people tend to increase their plaque volume over time, not surprising, and they recorded a 15% increase in total plaque volume over 4 years. But they discovered that if they gave them a garlic powder, and in this case they used 900 milligrams a day, the plaque did not grow. In fact, they even saw a slight reduction of about 2 to 3% in the group receiving the garlic powder. Now, in this trial, the difference was actually much clearer in women. In men, for reasons that are not completely clear, they weren't growing much plaque to begin with, so the garlic wasn't helping that much. The difference wasn't big. But in women, they were growing a lot of plaque, and so the garlic kind of rescued that, and the difference was big. But either way, this was a fascinating result. Now, both of these trials are older. They're both over 20 years old. But this question has been followed up on with newer techniques. This technique called CTA, computed tomography, angiography, that can show different types of plaque, not just calcified and not just total plaque, but actual soft plaque and subtypes of soft plaque. And in these more recent trials, they focused on a type of soft plaque called low attenuation plaque. So that's kind of a mouthful, low attenuation plaque. What does that mean? What is low attenuation? Why should anyone care? Low attenuation plaque corresponds to necrotic plaque, what people in this field call the necrotic core. Now, the necrotic core sounds like a character from Harry Potter or something like that, but it's actually the center of the plaque where cells start to die, and we call that necrosis. And it's a feature of high-risk plaque, of plaque that tends to burst and cause bad things like heart attacks and strokes. So people with plaques with more necrotic core and more low attenuation plaque, which indicates the necrotic core, tend to have more heart attacks and more strokes. It's nastier plaque overall. And so in one trial published in 2020, just a few years ago, they looked at diabetic patients, and they found that this low attenuation plaque, this presumably the necrotic core of the plaque, grew by 57% in 1 year. But when they gave them the AGE, the aged garlic extract, and in this trial they used a pretty large dose, 2.4 grams a day, the low attenuation plaque actually decreased by 29%. So that's a decrease of 29% compared to an increase of 57% seen in the controls, seen in normal conditions. So that's a pretty substantial, respectable difference. Another trial looked at people with metabolic syndrome, and they also found that the folks receiving the garlic extract, the garlic supplement, saw a decrease in low attenuation plaque. So these are really interesting and really promising results. Now, there's a number of questions that remain open. As always, this is almost always the case in science. There's always another question to answer. For example, in these newer trials, the total amount of plaque and also the calcified plaque was not significant. No significant difference between the garlic group and the placebo group. So this is different from those older trials, right? In the newer trials, they see a difference specifically in this low attenuation plaque, this subtype of soft plaque. This difference between the trials could be because of the different techniques that they're using, and the newer techniques maybe pick up something more subtle, more specific, or it could be because of the number of participants that isn't very large in these trials, tends to be in the dozens to maybe 100, 150 people in the largest one. So that's another limitation. These are not large trials, and so some caution is warranted there. The other thing we want to remember is plaque measurements are always a surrogate. They're a guesstimate. It's interesting to look at what happens with plaque size, but ultimately we only care about plaque to the extent that it reflects the risk of something we can actually feel, like heart attacks or strokes or erectile dysfunction or some issue, right, that causes a manifestation that actually bothers us. The plaque, if the plaque is silent, if the plaque is sitting there behaving well, we don't really care. So the million-dollar question is always, okay, what's the actual risk of heart attacks and strokes? It's just really hard to record that. You need very large trials over long periods of time. And so those are a luxury. We have many of those, but we can't easily get those for every product in the market. So we don't have those for garlic yet. That's a question mark. The evidence so far looks promising, really interesting. And another interesting thing is that historically there's other trials looking at garlic and garlic supplements, and they show, at least in some trials, a reduction in biomarkers of heart disease like blood pressure and cholesterol. This is not seen in every trial, but several trials do see it. So there's an indication there that the garlic extract may be doing some of these things that are beneficial at the end of the day, and that would align, if confirmed, with the reduction in plaque. Bottom line, this supplement is not going to replace your cardiologist or his or her advice. Absolutely pay attention to them, but maybe this can be an add-on to whatever you're already doing. Talk to your doctor and discuss it. Here's a lot more on reducing plaque with diet, and here's workouts that have been shown to help shrink plaque in your arteries. Check them out. I'll see you in there. Bye-bye.